Now, those of us that have had jobs in corporate America, if you've ever worked for anybody else, most often you have a very clear-cut schedule, okay? And you're expected to show up at a certain time. There are certain tasks that you're required to complete by a certain time each day, and so on. When you work for yourself, whether it's in Mary Kay or, you know, in any other business, that can be kind of tricky, okay? And if you're not a naturally disciplined person, that can be a real detriment to you. So I came up with something I'm calling the 4-hour plan. And it's a time management plan, literally, but it's kind of a fun game to play with yourself, too. So however you want to look at it, some of your personality styles want a structured plan. Some of you run screaming with your hair on fire away from structure. So for those of you that don't like structure, look at it as a game because it's fun, okay? But time management is especially important as we head into the holidays. But it's equally important every single day to be an entrepreneur, all right? So with that said, I'm going to walk you through what I, as I said, I'm calling Tammy's 4-hour plan. Now, hold on a minute. I got to pull up a different document here. Sometimes it can be tricky to navigate around all of these things. Hold on 1 second. Figure out where I saved it. Here it is. Okay. So title this, and you might want to put this on a separate piece of paper. If you've already been taking notes, get out a clean piece so that you can file this away with, that you can refer to it all by itself at another point. Okay? So title it The 4-Hour Plan for Beauty Consultants by Tammy Craig. Okay? Now, before I start into it, this plan is for the full-time beauty consultant who is willing to work 6 to 8 hours a day if necessary for herself. If you're currently working another job, a full-time job, or for whatever reason you cannot fit 6 to 8 hours a day into your schedule, it's okay. You just need to adjust the plan to fit your needs. In other words, once I finish explaining it to you, if 4 hours doesn't work, well, maybe 2 hours would work, or maybe even 1 hour would work, and you would still get benefits from it by being consistent, okay? And here's what I know. After 20 years of working for myself, the biggest gap that I have seen between successful and unsuccessful people is the gap between knowing what to do and actually doing it. And many of you listening to my voice right now have been with us in Mary Kay maybe for quite some time, 6 months, a year, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, you know, and I think you would agree with me that most of you in that group know what to do. This business is extremely simple, extremely simple. It's not easy, but it's very simple, not complicated at all. We teach people to wash their face, and we sell an amazing product, okay? But the gap between knowing what to do and actually doing it can be huge. So this plan, when implemented and used consistently, can fix that for you. Okay? A common statement that I hear from beauty consultants is, you know, if somebody would just give me a plan and tell me what to do like they do at real jobs in corporate America, I really would do it. Let me repeat that. If somebody would just give me a plan and tell me what to do, exactly what to do every hour of my day, just like they do in a real job, I would do it. So if you've ever thought that, or if you have ever said that, here we go. After this call, you won't be able to ask for that anymore because you'll have it, all right? So we're going to play the what-if game here. What if every day you spend an hour or a half an hour, you know, if you're, like I said, if you have another job, simply making booking calls, picking up the phone, using a bubble sheet, for those of you that know what that is, if you don't panic, and just dialing phone numbers. Pick up the phone, dial a number, have the conversation, get the voicemail, hang it up, and mark, give yourself credit on your bubble sheet for making a call. Pick up the next phone, dial the number, you know, have the conversation, set the phone down, mark your bubble sheet. What if you just did that 1 hour a day? Well, I believe you would book at least 2 classes in that hour, if not more. So here we go, 1 hour a day making booking calls, if it gave you 2 classes booked per hour, and you did that 5 days a week, you would book 10 skincare classes in a week. You would schedule them, you know, however it fits into your calendar, but you would literally be able to schedule 10 classes if you just booked 2 a day in that hour you set aside each day. Well, if you multiply 10 a week times 4 weeks for the month, you'd put 40 classes a month on your books. Now, at that point, you would be praying for cancellations, wouldn't you? You'd be going, man, I am praying half of this doesn't hold, because 40 classes is more than a class a day, right? Which isn't realistic for most people. Those of you that are full-time, of course you could do a class a day. But if you booked 40 because you spent that 1 hour a day focused and only half of them held, that would mean you would hold 20 classes per month. And if the average retail sales per class was $200, which is extremely conservative, but I worked this whole thing out very conservative so that, you know, really your numbers might be a lot better, but we're going to go conservative. So 20 classes at $200 retail per class would mean you would sell $4,000 in retail product just at those 20 classes, okay, which would give you a $2,000 wholesale order each month because you would be replacing your inventory, and $2,000 would be your profit less any expenses like hostess gifts and samplers used at the class, okay? All right, so we're going to just call it $2,000 profit and $2,000 in a wholesale order. Well, those of you that know about the Star Consultant Program, if you ordered $2,000 wholesale per month, that would give you $6,000 in Star credit per quarter, and you'd be up there in the really, really nice prizes category, or multiple prizes if you chose to go that route. But basically, you'd be earning a Star Consultant prize every single month, right? Because if the lowest prize category is $1,800, well, you'd be ordering $2,000 a month. So that's kind of exciting. But bottom line is, if you're selling $4,000 retail a month at those classes, that's $48,000 retail per year. And some of you already are ahead of me. You know that that is beyond what you need to do to be in the National Queen's Court of Sales. So get excited about that. If you don't know what the Queen's Court is, talk to your director, but it basically translates into the best of the best in Mary Kay and a beautiful bling bling diamond ring or other beautiful year-long prize from Mary Kay. So pretty cool that 1 hour a day, 5 days a week, could put that many classes on your books and put that kind of profit in your pocket. Now, moving on to the next hour of our 4 hour day, what if you did 1 hour of coaching calls every day? 1 hour of coaching calls every day. Now, coaching, of course, is working with your hostesses that are holding the classes to get the invite lists and then contacting those that are invited to what we call pre-profile them and find out if they're coming to the class and what their skin type is and color preferences, etc. So if you spent an hour a day coaching, you could coach a couple of classes a day. And the exciting thing about that is when you coach the class, it usually holds. And there's usually 6 to 8 people in attendance when it's done correctly. Now, for those of you that are new to Mary Kay, your director will be having you listen to it's either on a CD or on our website, you can choose, but a recording of what coaching is and details on how to do it. Those of you that have been in Mary Kay for any length of time, I'm sure you've listened to the coaching CD or the coaching recording. If you haven't, I just want to pray for you, okay? Because I do occasionally find people, even directors, that get all the way to directorship and say to me, I've never listened to your coaching CD, and I just want to cry. Because it's the single most important skill you must master to be good at this business. So enough said about that. You'll find coaching, the recording, on our website under audio visual training. Okay? All right. So the benefit of the hour of coaching each day is that your classes will actually hold, and you will start avoiding all those cancellations and postponements. They're only not holding because you're not coaching them. Okay? The third hour you would spend making customer service calls to existing customers. Now, for those of you that are brand new, you probably at first would use this hour and just add it to your booking time because you may not have any customers to call yet, okay? Those of you that don't have enough customers to make calls for a solid hour, then again, just don't eliminate the hour. Just add it to one of the other categories, okay? But if you had enough customers and you made an hour's worth of calls, I believe you would sell a minimum of $100 just calling to follow up with and see what your customers are needing, what they've run out of, because they will run out of their skincare that you sell them every 3 to 4 months. And sad but true, some of you have had customers for a year or two or three or five or ten that you've never called. So by now they might have moved on to using another product, but that doesn't mean you can't get them back, okay? But customer service calls, if you sold $100 an hour, think about it. That's only one miracle set replaced in an hour. So that's very conservative. But if you did $100 in sales a day for 5 days a week, that would give you 500 more in sales a week times 4 weeks for the month would be 2,000 sold, okay? So now what have we sold? Well, we sold 4,000 at our 20 classes, right? And we sold 2,000 in customer service calls. So now we've retailed $6,000 if no other customers just order by accident. Okay? So 6,000 retail means 3,000 in your pocket, less expenses, of course. But let's call it a $3,000 profit. Who could not get excited about that? Who could not discipline themselves for 3 hours a day to get to that point? Okay, your full-time corporate jobs usually are not going to pay you that for working a three-hour day. Okay, you know, a lot of people don't take that home in a month working an eight-hour day or a 10-hour day. And we've only talked about three of your 4 hours so far. Okay, all right, so let's move on. But now, wait a minute. Now we've retailed 6,000, so now our wholesale order each month is 3,000. That's a diamond star order every single month. And in a quarter, you would order $9,000 worth of product because you've sold it, okay? And now you're up to the highest level in those star prizes, which, you know, the higher the prizes go, the better they get. Get excited. Okay. Now, you've also made 1,000 more in profit from your customer service calls. Oh, I'm sorry. It was 1,000 more ordered, so you actually ordered 3,000. Yeah, I said 3,000. That was correct. But your profit is 1,000 more. So now we've profited, okay, 2,000 from our skincare classes and 1,000 from our reorder customer calls. We've made $3,000. And I can get pretty excited about that. Now, if you're not interested in team building at all, stop here with a three-hour day, and you're still pocketing $3,000. And I have to point out that profit will increase as reorders grow and grow and grow because your customer base grows and grows and grows. That'll just keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And you don't ever have to team build if you choose not to in Mary Kay, but I do have to say it's a very, very lucrative avenue of income. I was not going to recruit when I came into Mary Kay. And look at me now. I'm a national sales director because I fell so in love with this opportunity. I just could not stand to keep it to myself. I couldn't. It was unfair. I felt a very strong need to pay it forward to other people, and I hope you do as well. So if you did decide that you were going to work a four-hour day and you spent 1 hour making team building calls, which means you would be calling people to see if they would listen to the career opportunity, whether you sat down with them one-on-one and explained it, or you brought them to something your director was doing and she explained it, or they listened to the recorded call that we have on our website, which is me telling my I story and explaining the marketing plan, or they watched a DVD or listened to a CD. There's lots of different ways to have people listen to the marketing plan. But if you spent 1 hour a day calling people to schedule them to listen, or you actually went out and did a one-on-one interview for an hour, that would be considered team-building calls, okay? So if you booked 2 interviews per day during your hour, that would mean you'd book 10 interviews a week because 5 days times 2 interviews a day is 10 a week, and that would equal also 40 a month. And if only 20 of those held, 1 out of 5 people will generally sign up to become consultants. So 5 goes into 20 four times, but you would get probably 4 or 5 personal recruits a month by doing that. Now, chances are way more than 20 of your interviews would hold. So that recruiting number truly easily could be a gold medal, which is 5 personal recruits a month. Now, even if you're brand new to Mary Kay and you did that this month and you got 20, 25, 30 people in front of your director because maybe you don't know how to do the marketing plan yet, you could go on target to earn the use of your Mary Kay car your first month, just like many of our directors did and just like I did. Many people in Mary Kay have done that. It's a matter of doing the interviews, okay? But if you recruited 5 people because of that hour every day that you're spending, the average new person coming into Mary Kay will invest in $1,000 worth of inventory. Now, some of you, like me, did $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000. Okay, it's basically whatever you can finance or you can afford to do with your own money. But just so you know, the average person, some will start with nothing, some will start with $4,000 or $5,000. Okay, but the average person starts with $1,000. So if 5 people came onto your team and they each ordered an average of $1,000, that would be $5,000 in what we call personal team production. You would have 5 recruits, and if all of them were active and you had $5,000 in production, that puts you on target and completes month 1 of your car qualifications. That easy, that fast, you're in, you're done. Okay? And it's just not, it's not difficult if you're working the 4-hour plan. Okay? So, you're also paid, as you know, a commission on orders that are placed by people you personally bring into the business. So if your team production is $5,000, like we just talked about, and you're at the 13% commission level, and I'm not going to go into details of that, but you know, those of you that have been around a while understand you either make 4%, 9%, or 13% on team members' orders based on how many people you have on your team and how active they are and what your sales are. I mean, I'm not going to get into the complication of it, but I'm just going to assume you're going to get your 13% commission. So $5,000 times 13% Mary Kay will pay you for those orders is $650 in your pocket in the form of a commission check from Mary Kay. It has nothing to do with your sales. It's a second avenue of income. Plus, if you're a Red Jacket already with 3 active team members, every new person you add to your team that begins your business qualified, you get a $50 bonus. So if this is your 4th recruit or beyond, you have an opportunity to get $50 bonus for each of those qualified. So if just 2 out of the 5 are qualified, that would be 100 more in bonuses. If 5 out of the 5 came in qualified, that'd be $250 more in bonuses, and so on. So the grand totals that we're talking about here, you've made $3,000 profit on your sales, $750 between commissions and potential bonuses. So by becoming disciplined 4 hours a day, which is a part-time job, your income could be as much as or even more than $3,750, and the averages we used are very conservative. Chances are you could book a lot more than 2 classes an hour. You could sell a lot more than $100 an hour in customer service calls. You could end up with way more unit or personal recruits. So all of these numbers could be a lot higher. I just chose to be very conservative on them, okay? So you're close to $4,000 in Mary Kay income if you will discipline yourself to work the 4-hour plan and literally could be on target for your car this month. And those of you, I mean, that want to go to New Orleans and be at leadership conference with the best of the best in Mary Kay, all the directors, all the national sales directors, then this plan is what it's going to take for you to get there this month. But gang, I'm talking about a 4-hour-a-day job. It just floors me how many people are willing to work 8-hour days, 10-hour days, 12-hour days for other people who are not going to pay them even $4,000 a month. And I just told you how you can do it in a 4-hour day. Now, granted, you do still have to hold the classes and do the interviews, okay? But before I go on to explain that part of it, I have to tell you that this same plan, the 4-hour-a-day plan done by a director, just so you know the difference in income, the same activity a director will make between $9,000 and $10,000 doing the exact same number of classes, calls, all of it. Why? Because there are so many additional ways a director is paid because of what she's doing for the company and because of the larger bonuses she gets. Okay? So $3,750 as a consultant on the four-hour plan, or between $9,000 and $10,000, maybe even more, as a director. Just want to throw that out there for those of you that are toying with the idea of moving up to those leadership positions. I would say do it quickly because you're leaving a lot of money on the table. For those of you that directorship does not appeal to you, it's okay. You know, working 4 hours, 4 to 6, maybe 8 hours a day by the time you do your classes and whatnot, that's darn good income for being able to work for yourself. And it just grows and grows and grows as your team grows, as your customer base grows, you know, reorders grow. This is just starting out. Now, obviously, you do need to schedule time outside of these 4 hours to hold your classes that you're booking and to hold interviews and, of course, attend your weekly meeting. But let's just say, for example, on Monday, you do your four-hour day, and then you go to your sales meeting that night. Well, your meeting may be 2 to 3 hours, so you've worked a 6 to 7 hour day. Still, to make that kind of money and earn the use of a free car, I would say is worth it. Or you can go work in corporate America 8, 10, 12, 14 hours a day, not make that kind of money, and not earn a free car. Totally up to you, okay? But you do need to book the classes and you need to hold the interviews. So the four-hour plan, as I said before I even started explaining it, is designed for a full-time beauty consultant who is willing to work 6 to 8 hours a day when necessary. You may only hold classes 3 days a week, and one of those classes may be at your weekly meeting. So that's kind of killing two birds with one stone. So I think you'll understand as you start working it. Now, if the four-hour plan doesn't work because you have another full-time job or it's just, for whatever reason, it won't work, then cut it down to 2 hours a day and spend 30 minutes in each one of those categories, and then just cut the income in half at the end of the month. It was almost $4,000, so you'd still make close to $2,000, maybe more, and possibly eventually quit that full-time job as that income grows and matches and exceeds what you're making, and at that point you could become a full-time beauty consultant, okay? So it's very important, though, I have to say this, to physically assign times on your calendar each day for the activities. You can't just say, okay, I'm going to start working the four-hour day, I'm going to wake up tomorrow, and I'm going to start working it. No, you have to think like a dentist, a doctor, a lawyer, a teacher, okay, and literally write on a calendar, at 10 o'clock I'm going to do this, at 1 o'clock I'm going to do this, at 4 o'clock I'm going to do this, and at 6:30 I'm going to do this, okay? You can do these things out of order. It doesn't have to be book, coach, self-recruit, and it certainly doesn't have to be 4 consecutive hours. It can be whatever hours you want, but if you don't write it down and treat it like an attorney treats an appointment with a client, it will not happen. Just because you got the plan, just because you're listening tonight and you're getting all excited about it, don't think for 1 minute it's going to happen if you haven't literally committed yourself. So what I'm saying is tonight, if you're going to start this tomorrow, you literally print yourself out a calendar or you go to your electronic calendar and you make it look like a dentist, a doctor, an attorney with appointments scheduled, booking hour, coaching hour, selling hour, team building hour. Got it? So that's critical to the success of this program. Okay? Now, spend some of your profits that you're making here hiring someone to do the tasks that you do not need to be doing. For example, cleaning your trays after skincare classes. You can just drop your starter kit in your mudroom and your assistant, maybe she's a 12-year-old, okay, or a high school or college student, you know, comes for a couple hours a day, and she knows that that starter kit is sitting there, that she's to take it apart, clean it all up, restock it, and put it back all ready to go. Or making goodie bags for your classes. That's just, you know, menial work, you guys. Unpacking your product deliveries, et cetera, et cetera. Those are all menial tasks that make a beauty consultant feel like she's working all the time but not making any money because you are being, you know, distracted or you're using, you know, creative avoidance to do the four things we already talked about. So I encourage you to pay somebody minimum wage to do those things for you using the money that you're making. And while she's there or he's there doing those things, you need to be holding appointments, making money while they do it. That's a huge tip for you as well, because I know that some of you do all of that stuff, and it just is not profitable. If you can't book, coach, sell, or recruit it, you're not making money doing it. So you need to do what the dentists do. You know, they don't sit at their desk and book the appointments, and they don't clean all of their own utensils. They hire people to do that for them, and they use their time, which is more valuable, where they make money. Okay? All right, so as we wrap this up, and I know I'm 8 minutes over, 7 or 8 minutes over our hour, but I'm going to just run through some typical questions that I get, and if you have more questions, run them by your director, because I've already trained the directors on this program, and they can answer your other questions. But here are a few that I get right off the bat. Number one, what if I don't have enough leads or people to call to make 5 hours worth of calls this week? Okay? Well, the answer would be spend the hour, first of all, calling the ones you do have, and then get out the door and meet some new people with the tried and true ideas that your director has already or can give you. You know, call existing customers and book them again. Ask existing customers for referrals. Maybe offer them a discount for helping you with referrals. If they don't want to hold their own class, who can they refer you to? And how much discount are you willing to give them off their next order? And or use one of the ideas that your director is very aware of to buy leads. There's leads you can buy for $1, $1.25 a piece. Okay? But stop focusing on what you don't have and ask for help in ways to find leads. You guys, 91% of the people in your city are not currently using Mary Kay. So there is business all around you. You just have to pick the technique that feels most comfortable to you and do it. So again, that's something to run by your director. So if you're not on the call making the hours worth of calls, you should be using one of the ideas to meet new people. And then every class you hold, your director will teach you how to do the referral game, and you'll get better and better at that. And I firmly believe once you are a master at the referral game, you will leave every class with 50 to 60 new names, and you'll never run out of leads. Okay, but you have to start somewhere. The same holds true for all the other areas. If you don't have enough to do for a full hour in one of those categories, then move the time around to the other categories. So for example, I don't have enough leads, but boy, I do have 100 customers. Okay, well then maybe you're going to do 2 hours worth of customer service calls and so on and so forth. Okay, but spend the 4 hours in one of the four areas, or else get out the door and meet new people. Okay, next, if you, like I already said, if you're getting 50 or 60 referrals at every class, you're gonna always have enough people to call to book more appointments. And the more appointments you book after your first 2-3 weeks, you're gonna have so many classes on your books, you might need 2 hours worth of coaching time instead of one. So anyway, as you go along using this system, you'll know if you need coaching time, booking time, whatever. Okay? All right. Once you begin holding the classes, I think I'm getting ahead of myself, you'll book classes from classes. And very likely, you could eliminate the booking hour completely down the road. Okay? So you hold a class, and let's say you book 3 classes from it. Well, you know, eventually, you're going to get rid of that booking hour, but I would say don't get rid of it. Move it over to coaching and start coaching for 2 hours, or move it over to team building appointments and start doing, you know, maybe 2 of those a day or whatnot. So move it around that way. The more classes you book, the more time coaching and the more interviews you'll have, so on and so forth. Okay, just start, okay? Don't analyze this, just start, and the natural flow of things will come to you, and you'll know where you need to spend your time. Okay, question number 2, what if I get so many bookings on my books after week 2, I don't have anywhere else to put any more bookings? Well, then you use that hour again in one of the other 3 areas, okay? Third question I get, what if I'm afraid to get on the phone? I kind of addressed this earlier. Get a booking buddy and do it anyway. You must do the thing you fear the most, and soon the fear will go away. And just remember, if you've heard me train on fear before, if they say no, nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. You're not in danger. You know, if you don't take it personally, it doesn't feel bad. They just said no. How many times have you said no to the guy that calls you to sign up for Comcast or DirecTV? You know, he didn't crawl in a hole and go die somewhere. It's part of any business. Dentists, doctors, attorneys get told no, but they keep going. So if people say no when you're asking for a booking, nothing changes. You guys, nothing got worse and nothing got better. Everything's the same. But if they say yes, your business improves. So as long as you're asking, your business can only stay the same or get better. It only gets worse when you don't call because you choose to stay stuck in that fear zone, okay? Well, gang, unfortunately, we're out of time. I hope that this call has been beneficial for you, but really, truly, the only way that it can benefit you ultimately is if you implement it and just keep focused on the $3,000 to $4,000 a month you could make, and even cutting it down to a two-hour-a-day plan, you could pocket an extra, you know, $1,500 to $2,000 a month, or even, you know, cutting it down to an hour a day. You're still slowly growing your business. But just make sure that you don't completely decide not to implement it at all, because if nothing changes, nothing changes. And I appreciate you calling in. Stay tuned for the date on our next call, and I look forward to many success stories from each of you about the four-hour plan. Please go on to our Dream Central Facebook page and post that you were on the call tonight. Give me some feedback on what you heard. Let's blow the Facebook page up, okay? It's called Dream Central, and chances are, if you have not been linked into that page, you just need to talk to your director. She can get your name to my assistant, and she can add you. But many of you are on there, you just don't realize it. So go to Facebook, look on the left-hand side of your screen for pages, or groups, I think it's called. Look for groups, and you'll find one there called Dream Central. And let's just, you know, chat with each other and, you know, post your intentions there. And if you do the 4 hours tomorrow or even an hour of it, you know, get on there and say, so excited, I worked my four-hour plan today, and here were my results. Because your crowing does two things. It makes you feel good, and people will respond to that, but it also inspires other people to do the same. Okay, I adore you guys. We're on our way to Inner Circle, and I can't wait to see who implements it. Have a great day, and get selling for holiday as well. Bye-bye.